Throughout our history, we have found the remains of civilizations that, in our understanding, it's impossible that they could have existed. Great megalithic constructions, temples with astrological orientations, entire villages that border on the impossible in terms of their construction. All over the world, these constructions have amazing coincidences. Where we find similarities in their construction, we have also found an infinity of artifacts and other things in impossible places. Throughout the world, archaeological finds add up to thousands. We speak from new excavations in the pyramids of Egypt to certain findings that exceed the limit of traditional. Let's have a look at some examples. Africa, for example, vestiges of advanced civilizations. In Egypt, of course, we have the pyramids, those of Giza, and hundreds more. The temples such as Abu Simbel, Karnak, hundreds of obelisks and so on, distributed throughout Egypt. As in all the old buildings, the rocks unite perfectly, with joints so precise that we can't pass a sheet of paper between them. Although we're almost sure that use was given to each construction, the pyramids themselves are a mystery, since, although presented as tombs, no bodies were found in any of them. Some of them have a sarcophagus inside of them, but there's no body. In America, we also find the ruins of a civilization in the Amazon. Unfortunately, deforestation in combination with Google Earth has allowed the detection of 210 geoglyphs in 200 different sites in a strip of 250 kilometers long and 10 kilometers wide in the Amazon rainforest. Like the Nazca lines, the incredible geometric, zoomorphic and anthropomorphic designs of the Amazon can only be seen from the air. Numerous remains of what is obviously part of an ancient and hitherto unknown civilization have appeared under the trees of the Amazon jungle. According to the researchers, 260 huge avenues, long irrigation channels and livestock fences have been seen from the air. Always from the air, so that extraterrestrials see them? Tiwanaku also presents the type of megalithic construction with stacked rocks weighing several tons. The perfection in the joints of the rocks is so evident. Many of them there are up to three or four different unions. On one of the walls you can see the carvings of various types of faces. Caucasians, blacks, the typical Toltec heads and so on, in the middle of them. We can also see triangular heads with big round eyes that remind us of extraterrestrials. One step away from Tiahuanaco, we find Puma Punco, which is part of the tourist complex Tiahuanaco, a place where apparently a high-powered bomb exploded. We can see pieces of rock scattered around the place, and some of the carved rocks where you can see the work done. Straight lines, angles of 90%, stones that have triangular grooves that, when joining a rock to another, show us a perfect form of unison between the stones. Simply pouring molten copper into these grooves, when cooled, the support between the stones is strong and lasting. We also found several rocks in the shape of H, where the right angles are perfect. When approaching the stones, they present a perfectly smooth surface. Some theorists of the ancient astronauts believe that these rocks could have formed a kind of strong and firm esplanade, where the ships of the aliens descended and ascended. These rocks were carved from red andesite, a rock of extreme hardness. If we believe that these rocks were carried out with the rudimentary tools of the time, we are wrong. Tests have been carried out, making cuts with diamond discs, and even the perfect cut of stones could not be compared. Very close to there, in Bolivia, we find Sacsayhuaman. In this site, we find enormous walls formed by stones of up to 2.5 meters between 90 and 125 tons. Despite their size, the joints are so perfect that upon seeing them, we would believe that the stones were melted before placing them in their place. There is something more beyond the perfection of the cuts, also with joints between three or four stones or at 90 degree angles. That is, a stone is bent at an angle of 90 degrees to fit into two different walls. In Europe, the Roman Empire is a more than eloquent example. Bridges, aqueducts, roads that are still passable. Roman cement so strong that particularly they did not need structures to make their big constructions. It's a very important fact that this still could not be replicated. We also have examples of amazing buildings that challenge traditional history. For example, Malta presents a series of channels that run across the island in pairs. At first, The historians believe that they were marks left by cars, but for its depth and angle of curve, it's impossible for this to be. The theorists of the ancient astronauts say that these marks, in fact, could be channels where cables were driven. Truth or lie, we still do not know what they were made for and what they were for. Also in Malta, there's a series of temples with megalithic rocks, also stacked with perfect joints and with rocks that exceed 60 tons. And not only this, we also find the Hypogeum, hypo below geum earth. It's believed that it was excavated from the living rock back in 2500 BC. It's a prehistoric temple. It is said to be the only one of its kind. The caves of Longyu and Hosham in China are a series of caves dug into the living rock, where the ancient inhabitants carved with precision columns, rooms, stairs, and so on. It's believed that they moved about 1 million cubic meters of rock. They were discovered by chance in 1992, when a Chinese farmer began pumping water from one of the ponds in the area. To his surprise, he discovered that this was not a pond, but a large cave, with more than 30 meters in height at some points. For 17 days, they pumped water and then entered, and they found a cave of about 2,000 square meters. But it's not just one cave. They continued to pump water from other caves, and the current account is 24. And if we talk about digging rock, we can't forget Derinkuyu in the Cappadocia region in Turkey. Discovered in 1962, Derinkuyu has several levels, 20 in total, of which only 8 are open to the public. The rest are either obstructed or can only be visited by archaeologists and historians. Inside the citadel, you can find stables, halls, corridors, worship halls, and even kitchens, where you can still see soot on the walls and ceilings. There are also 52 ventilation channels and several exhaust tunnels, which gives us the idea that the citadel was used as a hiding place for many, many people. Also excavated in the rock, we have the caves of Ajanta. They were excavated in the Yadri mountain range. They were built in the shape of a horseshoe over the ravine around the river Vaghora. Several stairs take us to different levels of the excavated caves that were created for the monks' refuge. As we can see, certain constructions were made as refuge, others as places of worship, and others only as a dwelling. Australia is not indifferent to these issues. In 1939, Frederick Slater, president of the Australian Archaeological Research and Education Society, studied the so-called Stonehenge of Australia. Incredibly, after these first investigations, the place was lost for 63 years. At that time, it was said that the disposition and perfection of the stones never before or after was seen in Australia, and they even dared to date them before the original Stonehenge. That is to say, the theory that humanity was not born in Africa but in Australia is being raised. Slater says, "The mound is one of the oldest. I could say the oldest, and the temple forms are the oldest in the world. They exist since the arrival of the first man. If so, it would be proved that the first humans appeared in Oceania and from there spread throughout the globe." It's striking that, within the existing tribes in Australia, mainly and throughout Oceania, there were different skin colours, and also different languages and dialects. It's also known that in Australia alone, there are around 250 languages and about 600 dialects. We find this type of structure in America, Africa, Europe, Asia, and Antarctica. Current technology allows reaching points in the world where it was previously impossible. William James Veal is an engineer at Southampton College of Technology. Veal designs unmanned aerial vehicles, or drones, to reach inaccessible places, and describes himself as a satellite archaeologist, and claims that a prehistoric civilization may have sculptured what appears to be huge human heads, animals, and symbols on the Antarctic surface. Veal interprets satellite photographs showing large human heads, animal portraits, and symbols sculpted on the ground, which he has taken from Cape Adare, the northeastern peninsula of Antarctica. If its interpretations are correct, it would mean that an advanced civilization created these forms thousands of years ago. This contradicts the conventional timeline, which holds that Antarctica was not discovered until the early 19th century AD. As we see, in all the continents we have great buildings, perfect walls, astronomically aligned temples, large underground constructions, and so on, which gives us the pattern that there was another humanity before ours, that was technologically advanced and that disappeared without leaving more traces than the constructions that survive it.